Gotta love people that come out to like old Labyrinth songs. Joe Gasgoine from BMAC, Banbury Martial Arts Center. Ted Planet Training Center as well, I believe.
When this song came out, Steve, I remember I was at a Thai boxing show, and there was many fights where both fighters had the same song, because everyone loved this song.
It's an absolute banger, I have to say, Chris. But enough about Labyrinth, because he hasn't done anything in a while, and Joe Gasgoine is going to be doing something imminently in the 61-kilo bantamweight division. He's coming through, and we've seen a lot of very good fights in the bantamweight division this weekend, last weekend, and it's really time for somebody to come forward and take that world crown.
Well, let me frame this fight for you, Steve. We have Joe Gasgoine fighting out of BMAC, which is Banbury Martial Arts Club. It's actually really well known for its elite Thai boxing, right? And standing across the cage from him, we will have Mr. Joe Bonassisa, who's representing Osma, which is a very traditional karate school. We have Thai boxing versus karate.
Oxford School of Traditional Martial Arts, indeed, from Joe Bonassisa. It's the Battle of the Joes. Average Joes. Thai boxing versus karate. Now, karate is a defensive art. It's not supposed to be used in anger, but so help me God. He's no sissy, Bonassisa. He's the man, the myth, the legend out of Oxford School of Traditional Martial Arts, and he's looking to make some huge waves in the bantamweight division. He came down to RGA Box 2 weeks ago and was there for some sparring. He was sparring flyweight standout and pro Tom Creasy, and he actually looked pretty good. Mostly Tom Creasy will sit somebody down within 3 minutes, and Joe was able to hold his own for that. He didn't get completely winded. So he's coming in great shape. He's had a very good camp. He had a bit of a tough weight cut. He's looking very thin through the face even today. But we'll see how that pans out for him, possibly in the later rounds. But as we've seen today, Chris, it doesn't take very long to finish some fights here. We've had a whole score of first round finishes. So folks, if you're gonna have a drink, get up, get to the fridge, take a tinkle, pop your can open, maybe grab two. I'm always a two beer. You know, go to the fridge, get two beers, get some nuts, sit down, and, you know, glue your eyes open, because if you blink, you might miss it.
A bit of a veteran here as well. Joe Bonassisa has been coming out to the Battle Arena cage now for a couple of years regularly. Experienced fighter. And, you know, I think it's one of those things where he's got that traditional karate background, and he's a karate black belt, does a little bit of teaching as well. But he's mixed in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, he's mixed in the wrestling, and sometimes that's really interesting when someone has that traditional martial arts background, but they can blend in these other elements to make such a well-rounded fighter.
Exactly, that's the only way you survive in this ocean where everybody's a shark and all they're doing is filing their teeth. And that's the way that they do it, by adding new techniques, adding different disciplines. Joe Bonassisa with the very traditional bow there as he enters.
And that's the most conditioned I've looked since Joe Bonassisa look. The boys look a little bit soft, but look shredded today.
Yeah, some big noise made there for Joe Bonassisa there.
So we have Gasgoine in the blue, Bonassisa in the black.
And like you said, Chris, it's going to be it's a clash of styles here. BMAC, very known for their Thai boxing and their no-gi grappling.
Bonassisa straight into that karate position. What a beautiful, very MVPS, just catching the right.
Big knockdown there to start us off. Gascoigne's got to feel that one. Bonassisa doing well to block across the hips there, so preventing the knees from landing. But a big knee lands for Gascoigne. He dives right in on a double leg.
And that's been the one criticism of Osma when we've seen them on the show before. Maybe they're not quite as good as some of these other teams who are wrestling.
Bonassisa did really well there to wrap the head and use it to get back to a guard.
Yeah, I know Bonassisa was very comfortable off his back, looking almost rubber guard then, and looking but working a high guard to getting his legs high. And he stopped Gasgoine getting any ground and pound going. Bonassisa, hip bump sweep maybe.
He's definitely staying very active off of his back here.
Gasgoine getting his arm in just the wrong place. Bonassisa now playing butterfly, looking for a triangle.
He's controlling that far wrist quite well. His left hand.
I mean, it's not the most subtle of setups, but it could work. Trying to get his leg over that arm, set up a triangle choke. It hasn't worked. But he's recovered. Oh, but now he has.
Now he is. He's got the lock. Can he finish? He needs to underhook the leg.
That looks tight. Very tight. I think this is over.
Big squeeze, and maybe he can get the finish. He's got to be pounding. He should look to strike from here.
Bonassisa needs to be patient. Super patient. Just hold the choke. He needs to be patient.
He's got to settle in here.
Low. He's got the arm as well. He's got options here.
It's a bad sign when they start trying to strike out of it.
He's got the arm. He's tapping. It's all over. Huge win for Bonassisa.
Awesome. Awesome to settle in there. Very strong. Just wow. Wow from Joe Bonassisa. Blast through. Catches a kick. Quick knockdown at the beginning. And then we saw Gasgoine almost running away with it with the big double leg.
With that karate reverse punch in the first few seconds, landed on the chin, and then all Bonassisa off his back. Beautiful example of jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, wonderfully. It's showing, it's like you were saying, showing that evolution over time. How you do, how a team that is very traditional, mostly karate-based, and you get such a, well, it's a very flashy finish, a triangle, and then sticks with it and stays on top and gets the finish. I know Joe Bonassisa must be over the moon with that. I know his team is for sure. Wow. So Chris, it's a reverse punch. Caught it. Reverse punch there. Wow. Any other cool techniques? What would you call that in karate? What's the Japanese word for reverse punch?
I've forgotten.
Oh dear. Sorry about that. Right.
Steve's going to go catch up with Joe in just a moment.
If you wonder why we're choosing our interviews, it's actually based upon height. So
it's not that's not Steve, that's me. I feel self-conscious making these amazing athletes look small. I'm 6'5". I don't mean to be a giant. It's just the way I was born. My father ate too much, and I ate too much.